kind of hot.
Like growing up in the projects, it was really hard though. You know what I mean? We had to go rob, you know what I mean? Tear it up to really eat, you know what I mean? Because we was young, nobody wanted to give us nothing. You know what I mean? The homies was just teaching us different types of shit. So we went on our own one night, you know what I mean? We go do some other shit because we needed money, you know what I mean? Right. So we was out doing what we had to do to survive, you know what I mean? Survival was a motherfucker growing up. So, you know what I mean? We go to the weed spot, we try to rob the drug that had the weed, and we, you know what I mean? We got on there, came out shooting. We retired, we turned shooting back, we died. You know what I mean? Then my partner get then, you know, we driving, I'm talking to my partner, he ain't responding. You know what I mean? He was hit, so he wasn't in the car. So he was laid out, you know what I mean, on the sidewalk. Yeah, so I hopped out the car and I told him to stop and hopped out the car and, you know what I mean, walked back to where it was at. You know what I mean? The homeboy was on the ground, you know what I mean, clinging for his life. So I had to grab him, you know what I mean? About time I had him in my arms, he left. Gone. That was the most coldest shit that I seen, you know what I mean? So that taught me a lot right there. That made me understand life a little bit better. So it was just me. You know what I mean? That was my life. It was my environment. That's what it was. California, yeah, it's like a baby Iraq, you know what I mean? They're running around with choppers, you know what I mean? Different shit with donuts on them, you know what I mean? You know, you got the drum on it, you know what I mean? You got that drum on it. It might hold 50, 100. It goes.
When you're a teenager, you're growing up in the environment, you know what I'm saying? Like the projects, you see all type of shit, you know what I'm saying? You can see dead bodies laying on the floor. You can see, you know what I'm saying, people getting shot. You know what I'm saying? You could walk outside, you know what I'm saying, seeing somebody get robbed. You know what I'm saying? You can see the police beating people. You know what I'm saying? Police killing people. You can see all type of things.
One day I witnessed this, you know what I mean, the police, they had like dirty. You know what I mean? I just hear police sirens. One day I heard police sirens one morning, and you know what I mean? I look out my window and see, you know what I mean, the police shoot my partner in the back. You know what I mean? My older, one of the elders from that neighborhood, from my neighborhood. Gang injunction is like, you know what I mean, they labeled your neighborhood a bad neighborhood, you know what I mean? They trying to keep you from seeing your friends that you grew up through rocks with, ate dirt with for years, you know what I mean? How am I not living, how am I living in an environment and not be able to hang with my friends? I went to 102nd Elementary School. We was like 8 years old gang banging at that school, you know what I mean? We used to fight all the time, like, you know what I mean? Every day, like, I used to fight.
There was a lot of problems. That's how most of the kids, you know, I had, he always had problems. I had to learn, really, he had to fight.
The police beating people, you know what I'm saying? Police killing people. You can see all type of things.
One day I witnessed some shit, you know what I mean? The police, they hella dirty. At 102nd, it was a lot of shit going on. Little older niggas used to drive up, you know what I mean? They knew it was from the projects. So they used to try to taunt us, you know what I mean? Looks and got shot and all that shit in front of the elementary school, after school and shit, you know what I mean? Ziggy's dad's coming to get him that's from the neighborhood, you know what I mean? One of the kids got hit back in the day. So, you know, it was heavy, it was hard. It played kind of fucked up on my site. That's when I started like really thinking about what I was gonna do, whether or not I was gonna go to school full time when I was young, or I was gonna turn out to be just like the niggas that was doing all of this. Okay.
Growing up in the projects, you gonna have to be tough.
I became a Muslim when I was young. When I was like 11. You know what I mean? I was straddling the fence trying to figure out what I wanted to be. But yeah, when I was young, I used to sneak out the house, go to my little best friend house, Oi. You know what I mean? That's my best friend. We call each other Oi. You know what I mean? I used to go to his house, sneak out of his house, sneak out of my house and go jump out the window, project window, and just go to his house and go eat something. One night I was on my way going to go, you know what I mean, eat at my partner house, chill out with him, you know what I mean? Zig into Oregon, you know what I mean? It expired, you know what I mean, to where, you know what I mean? And they got popped and they, you know what I mean? You know what I mean? They ran off. You know what I mean? I sit there, looked at the engine. You know what I mean? I watched the engine pass right there. You know what I mean?
So
I was a bad thing. You know, my mom, my mother and father and them was always gone, out partying, doing what they wasn't supposed to do. You know what I mean? So, you know what I mean? It made it hard for me, you know what I mean? Because, you know what I mean, I needed that family. So that's why I turned it. But I was, you know what I mean, turned to the neighborhood. I turned to being from Baby Love. You know what I mean? So, you know what I mean? That's how I was. The artists that influenced my life when I was young was the homie Big D, you know what I mean? Tupac. Brenda's got a name, but Brenda's South Central Cartel. A damn shame, the crooked Molly's fellow name. That's not our problem, that's NWA. Something Brenda's family. Well, let me show you how it affects our whole community. Now, Brenda really never knew her moms, and her dad was a junkie putting death into his arms. It's sad, cause I bet Brenda doesn't even know. Just cause you're in the ghetto doesn't mean you can't grow. I connected with them because they come from the same environment that I was in. You know what I mean? They was always rapping and doing, you know what I mean? They've been through a lot, like I have, you know what I mean? Not probably as much as I have, but they've been through a lot, you know what I mean?
Growing up in the projects, it is a harsh life. You know what I'm saying? It brings you to reality at a young age. You gotta go through things that normal teenager and normal youth don't go through.
I started going to juvenile hall when I was 9 years old. 9, 10. You know what I mean? LP, Central, Sillmore, camps. I done been through all that. I done did it all the time, man.
Yeah, juvenile hall, it did, you know what I mean, train me for what was the next to come. You know what I mean? I made it to the pen, it was crazy. So, you know, I did the time. When I was doing time, it made me realize, man, that I couldn't win. You know what I mean? So what I did was this time when I got out the pen, I've been out like 6 years now. So, you know what I mean? I stayed away from all of this. So, you know what I mean? I'm still about that life, but I stayed away from all of this. So when I went to pen, I struggled with a lot of adversities in my life. You know what I mean? So I had to change something about my life to really understand life, period. So I had to study books and people and understand things, and you know, it was just a whole outlook. My whole outlook on life was different. The things that's going on in my motorcycle club, it helped me through a lot because, you know what I mean, I get a chance to ride bikes, but it's good. You know what I mean? It's discipline, you know. We got a lot of people that's real brothers. They act like, you know what I mean, it's a family thing. We all family. It's, man, go to school, stay away from people like how I used to.